Thank you very much. And so I'll talk about my work, which is still in progress. It is a natural continuation of my previous work on vanishing cycles for formal schemes, and which was related to number theory. And so this work, in fact, as far as I understand, has no any relation to number theory. And so I apologize, but I warn Bharkov about that. And so it's related to complex analytic geometry, in fact. And so, but it's about vanishing cycles. And so I recall the definition of vanishing cycles, sheaves, and basic facts. And after that, I'll explain my results. And so vanishing cycles, sheaves will appear in three frameworks. The first one is algebraic geometry, then formal geometry, and third, complex analytic geometry. And so I'll start with algebraic geometry. It's mostly because it gives some general idea what it is. And so assume that we have R Henselian discrete variation ring. Example, immediately, the ring of convergent power series at zero, or convergent power series in a neighborhood of zero on the complex plane. Now, I'll denote by K fraction field. And temporary, it's the residue field. And I assume, just to save some space on the blackboard, that it is, so assume this field is algebraically closed. It's not a restriction at all, but it requires some additional pictures. And so we have the following diagram of schemes, morphisms of schemes. So first of all, spectrum of K, spectrum of R, spectrum of R tiled, and also spectrum of the algebraic closure of K. And so it's there are the following morphisms, and it is in fact the Galois. It's so the Galois group of this extension, we denote by G. Now assume that we have a scheme. For example, finite type over R, then we have the following diagram of morphisms. So X eta generic fiber, it's a preimage of the spectrum of K, a generic fiber of X, a closed fiber of X, which is the preimage of the spectrum of the residue field, and also X and so it's just lifting of the generic fiber to the algebraic closure of K. And so the vanishing cycles functor, which I call it, it's the functor from the category of sheaves on the special fiber of X to the category of sheaves on the, or from the generic fiber of X to the category of etal sheaves on the special fiber of X, but in fact all those sheaves are provided with an action of G, a continuous action of G of the Galois group, and it is defined as follows. So we start from a sheaf, and so sheaf F is a sheaf, etal sheaves on generic fiber. We consider its pullback F bar to this scheme, and this functor takes we consider push forward of this sheaf and pull back. it is a definition. And so it's a left exact functor, and so we can consider also its high direct images for abelian sheaves. And let me only remind the known fact. By the way, it's a definition from SGA 7, exposé 13 by Deligne. And so the fact is, if F is a constructible Z over NZ module, but N is assumed to be prime to the characteristic of R type, then all high direct images of this functor are constructible sheaves. And so it is a fact from SGA 4.5. Okay, it's the definition. Now let me switch to formal geometry. Okay, and so here we consider, we start from a non-Archimedean field K, non-Archimedean field with discrete variation. First of all, I'll recall some definition, discrete variation. And so now I also assume here, let me remind you that it is a notation for the ring of integers. The ring of integers, it's a local ring with a maximal ideal which is denoted in such a way, and so consists of elements A whose absolute value is strictly less than 1, and the quotient is denoted in such a way, which is, we assume, again, we assume just for simplicity that this field is algebraically closed. It's also not. Eventually, I only consider, in fact, you'll see something like such fields. So by the way, the ring of integers is an example of such a Henselian discrete variation ring. And so now let me remind you definition. A special formal scheme over the ring of integers is a formal scheme which is a locally finite union. In fact, we'll consider only quasi-compact finite unions eventually, a union of open subschemes of the form, the formal spectrum of A, where A is an adic ring of the following form, T1, Tm, by an ideal. And so it's a ring of restricted power series, a convergent power series on the unit ball, and it is a ring of formal power series. So, and A is an ideal in this ring, and so this ring is Noetherian, and so all ideals are finitely generated. And so it is an adic ring, an adic ring with respect, for example, of the to the following ideal. And so we consider, first of all, this ring, the ideal generated by variable S1, Sn, and W is a generator of the maximal ideal of the ring of integers. And so the image of this ideal in this ring A is also an ideal, and A is complete with respect to this powers of this ideal. And so such a formal scheme, and so, okay, let me could write, okay, if X is a formal, special formal scheme, over K, the ring of integers, and so it, one can associate with it so-called closed fiber, which is the topological space is just the same space X, but the structural sheaf is the quotient of the structural sheaf of X, factorized by an ideal of definition. And so, in fact, ideal of there is a maximal ideal of definition. It's not necessarily, we eventually are interested in topology of the space, etal topology, so it's not so important what is an ideal of definition. And so also such a formal scheme has a generic fiber, which is a K analytic space. So I, for example, for if X is the spectrum, formal spectrum of that ring, which is written here, what generic fiber is just a set of all points of the fine space of dimension m plus n, such that Ti of X is at most 1, Sj of X is strictly less than 1, and f of x equals to 0 for all f from the ideal A. It's an okay, and so now I do not give, I don't remind the definition of vanishing cycles functor, I only say the general picture, describes the general picture, and so one can define a left exact functor from the category of sheaves on the generic fiber of X, which is a K analytic space. It also has etal topology to the category of etal sheaves on the closed fiber, but those etal sheaves are provided with continuous section of the Galois group. So G is a Galois group of K. It's there is such a functor. And so what are important facts about this functor? And so first of all, what is an example of such a formal scheme? Let me, okay, let me return for a moment. Example of such a formal scheme. If X, and so I denote formal schemes by Gothic letters, and so here it's just calligraphic X scheme. If S is a scheme of finite type, over the ring of integers. So first of all, its formal completion along X closed fiber, which is also defined by the maximal ideal of the ring of integers, is an example of a special formal scheme, even special formal scheme of finite type. And so, in fact, this part is absent. And but also we can consider for any subscheme of the closed fiber of this scheme, we can consider even formal completion of the previous formal scheme along this subscheme. So also it is an example of a special formal scheme. Now, let me list some facts which true in this situation. First fact, important. For any, and so if X is a scheme of a scheme of finite type of the ring of integers, I do not write for finite type, and Y is a subscheme of its closed fiber defined by the maximal ideal of the ring of integers, and F is a constructible z over nz module on the generic fiber of this scheme, but with the condition that n is prime to the characteristic of the residue field, then the following is true. And so we can consider vanishing cycles, sheaves, or even object of the derived category, which is defined here in algebraic geometry. And if we restrict it to this subscheme X, then it turns out that there is a canonical isomorphism. Okay, now I'll explain the notation. Let me just explain. And so if we have X and Y, we can, so there is, okay. And so there is a canonical morphism from the generic fiber of this special formal scheme to the generic fiber of the scheme X, and so such that any sheaf F has its pullback. A tall sheaf F on this scheme, one can consider its pullback on this K analytic space. And so it is a notation for this sheaf. And so the statement is that, in fact, the restriction of the vanishing cycle sheaves, algebraic geometry, vanishing cycle sheaves to a subscheme of the closed fiber depends only on the formal completion of this scheme along this subscheme. And so what is good here, because this construction is functorial, and so if you have a morphism between two formal schemes, then we have functorially defined morphism between vanishing cycle sheaves. And so it is useful to know, for example, the automorphism group of this formal completion, the automorphism group of this formal completion, it turns out acts on this sheaves, which is good. And it turns out that also this action is continuous in a very natural way. Okay, but let me also mention the following fact. And so one can define, again, X is a formal scheme, special formal scheme. One can define constructible sheaves it is something which I did recently, constructible on the generic fiber, which is a K analytic space. So I can define a class of sheaves, which is naturally to call constructible sheaves. And so one can show that, again, if it is constructible with torsion orders, torsion prime to the the characteristic of the residue field of K, then the vanishing cycle sheaves are constructible. And so it's an analog of this fact, but in fact, in the proof of this statement, one uses this fact from algebraic geometry and something else. And for example, if you have lambda is a finite abelian group, finite or finite G module. And so one can associate with it the constant sheaf, not constant, some locally constant sheaf on the generic fiber of X. And so it is an example of such a constructible sheaf. Then all those sheaves are constructible, but what is if you have a morphism between formal schemes, and so as I mentioned, the construction is functorial, one can associate with it the following homomorphism from, let me write down, And so one can, functoriality means that if you start from a finite G module and consider the sheaf associated with it on the generic fiber on X, and also it defines a similar sheaf on the generic fiber of Y. And so if you have such a morphism, it induces such a homomorphism. And continuity statement says the following. So let me I erase this property. And so the statement is that continuity. So given X, Y, and lambda, there exists an ideal of definition of Y such that for any pair of morphisms from Y to X which are congruent modulo this ideal of definition, these two homomorphisms coincide. Okay. So it's all I wanted to mention. And the last framework, and so which is very far from here, it's a complex geometry. So here, complex geometry. So instead of Jensenian local ring, we consider a disk, small open disk in the complex plane, which contains zero. And so we have punctured disk, D star, it just complement D complement of zero, and we have zero, the point zero. So everything is on the complex plane. Now let us consider, instead of this algebraic closure, a universal covering of this punctured disk, which can be identified with upper half plane. And so the fundamental group of, let me write pi, which is fundamental group of the punctured disk, acts on this universal cover. So we have such a diagram. Now it is an analog of this diagram. If you have a complex analytic space over D, then we have a similar diagram, the following diagram. And in fact, in more slightly more general, we are not precisely interested. Usually, one doesn't, one is not interested by the whole preimage of zero, but just some closed subspace of zero. Now I'll explain why it is so. And so we have such a diagram. And so it's it is a notation for the preimage of the punctured disk. Now we lift it. So it is just such a complex analytic space, fiber product. And it is the usual closed embedding from Y to X. So Y is a subspace. And so a typical example of such a situation, for example, we have, which is very popular, if we have a germ of analytic analytic function around zero in n-dimensional space. And so X, just some small neighborhood of zero, but we are interested. Now let me finish the definition. And so vanishing cycles functor in this situation is a functor on from the category of sheaves on the generic fiber, which is defined in such a way, usual sheaves, it's to the category of sheaves on Y, provided with the action of the group pi, and it is defined as follows. And so similar, we consider sheaf F here. We consider its pullback to this analytic space. And so F goes to the following. I checked that here I had to write this. It is defined as completely in a similar way like here. And so why I considered such a situation, why not the whole preimage? Because if we have a germ of analytic function that in fact a small neighborhood of zero, let me denote it by B, there is a analytic small, for example, open ball maps to C. And so we in complex geometry, one interested with not with the whole. And if you have a sheaf like a similar, which is defined in a just outside the preimage of zero, and we are interested only with the restriction of the sheaf or with the stock of the sheaf at zero. And so zero is just this y. Okay. In fact, let me give you a more general situation of which I'll consider. And so we have a germ of a morphism of germs of analytic spaces, complex analytic spaces. Yes, even more general situation. And we have a scheme X, scheme of finite type over the local ring of B at the point B. I'm sorry, here it's not zero, it's just abstract analytic space. It's not necessary that B is smooth. And if you have a scheme of finite type over over this local ring, then we can associate with it a complex analytic space, analytification, but in fact, which is an analytic space over B, over this analytic space. And in fact, if we shrink B a little, and so we have such a even a morphism from the analytification of X, it's to B and to C. And so we are interested, in fact, with vanishing cycles. So if we define, now if we for a moment forget about this B, and so the generic fiber of this, we define just generic fiber of this analytic space is the preimage. Let me denote this compositional by G, and so it's F. It's a G the preimage of C star or of this punctured disk. We could write D here. And but instead of considering the preimage of zero, it's reasonable to consider, let me denote in such a situation H, the preimage, let me denote this by H. Ah, H, they have different, let me denote V. V, the preimage of this point B, it's a smaller, it lies in the preimage of zero. And so it's precisely situation we considered here. Then one can apply this construction. And so let me also mention certain facts, which are one knows facts. First of all, comparison theorem. In this situation, now I consider this situation. If F constructible Z over NZ module on this generic fiber of X. And so X, generic fiber, I mean that it's over the fraction field. Also X, let me be precise, it's X tensor over O C zero over the fraction field of this ring. And so if you have constructible Z over NZ module et al, then the following is true. Then there is a comparison theorem that vanishing cycles sheaves of F And so it is a sheaf on, if you consider it's like the restriction to XS, and so just we consider this sheaf, it's a sheaf I defined there on the whole preimage of zero, but now we restrict to what I define, the preimage of B. And we can consider analytification of this sheaf, and so this sheaf is already lives on this complex analytic space. It is precisely the vanishing cycle sheaves of the analytification of this sheaf, also restricted to this. And so the left-hand side comes from algebraic geometry, the right-hand side is defined here. Now, also important fact is, therefore one can show, for example, X can coincide with just the spectrum of this local ring, like one considers in the situation with Milner fiber. And so the next fact is if lambda is finitely generated abelian group, which is also a pi module, where pi is a, and so such a finitely generated abelian group gives rise to a locally constant sheaf on the punctured disk or on the C star, and so we can lift it to a sheaf on this. It gives rise to a sheaf on the analytic space, analytification of this analytic space. And so the fact is that the vanishing cycle sheaves of such a sheaf, which is defined here, are constructible. Now I'll explain, I recall it is important, which is called algebraically constructible. Constructible on the analytification of the closed fiber of S. Now, what is, does it mean that in complex analytic geometry that a sheaf is constructible? Let me remind you. And so if you have Y, so a scheme of finite type over C, then a sheaf F on Y, on the analytification, is called, let me remind you, is algebraically constructible. So I'll omit algebraically constructible if there exists a decreasing family sequence of Zariski closed subsets. Such that the restriction of F to each yi minus yi plus 1 h is locally constant with finitely generated fibers. So in algebraic geometry, we consider only torsion sheaves. Here, we can allow ourselves to consider more general class of sheaves, namely sheaves which, like for example, associate with finitely generated abelian groups. And so it's a locally constant with finitely generated stocks. Okay, it is an example of such a sheaf. Okay. Now I can formulate already, I reminded, and so what I wanted. So, I see that I have some space here, but just I use it to introduce notation. So first of all, let me introduce notation. And so it is a derived category. It's a full subcategory of the derived category of pi modules. But such that cohomology of complexes are finitely generated over Z. Over Z. So finitely generated abelian groups. Just pi modules, for example, if it's just a pi module which is finitely generated is an abelian group. It's one notation. And if Y is a scheme of finite type over C, I denote in such a way. It's already more or less standard notation. It is a derived category of abelian sheaves on the analytification with constructible cohomology sheaves. Constructible in the sense of this definition. So now, let K big be a non-Archimedean field. Over C, over the field of complex numbers with discrete valuation. And with the property that the residue field of K is just C. So it fields, this field contains C and its residue field is C. In fact, one can, it follows from K is isomorphic to just to the field of Laurent power series, non-canonically. But just I consider K as an abstract field with these properties. So it's precisely. Okay, now the Galois group of this field is canonically isomorphic to the projective limit of groups of n of groups of nth root of unity, and so it contains a subgroup, and so of course it is isomorphic. Now I'll explain. It contains a subgroup, pi, which is generated by the following element. So we consider just there is a canonical generator in this group. And so just pi is generated by this canonical generator. And in particular, pi is canonically isomorphic to Z, and this group is canonically isomorphic to Z hat. Okay. Now I can theorem. I hope that I mentioned everything before that. So one can construct an exact functor from the derived category I introduced there of pi modules with finitely generated cohomology and bounded complexes B, as usually stands for, to the derived category also. Here, what I write, given a quasi-compact packed special formal scheme X over the ring of integers of K, one can construct an exact functor to the following category. So we consider the analytification of the special fiber of X. So special fiber is just a scheme of a C of finite type. It's an analytification. And we consider the category of sheaves provided with the action of this group pi. And so here is a notation for the image of a sheaf. So if you have lambda dot, an object of this category, its image will be denoted in such a way. And so all this is a notation. It is not a derived functor. It's just notation. Okay, and so one can construct an exact functor from this category to this category. Now I'll justify this notation. And so such that the following is true. Now I list several properties of this. First one, the correspondence X goes to this complex is functorial. Is functorial in X. What does it mean? Let me spell out it precisely. This means that for any morphism between formal schemes, quasi-compact special formal schemes over the ring of integers, one can associate with it a homomorphism. Oh, in this notation, I'm sorry, I write here H just to emphasize that it's something different. H, it comes from, H stands for holomorphic. Holomorphic, it's so just. It's a whole notation, and so this means that if we have then a homomorphism FSH star R, so and so we can associate, functorial means that with any morphism we can associate such a homomorphism, which is similar to this homomorphism, just similar. It looks at, this means that composition, if we have a composition, we have a composition here in the evident event. If phi is identity, then it is identity. So it's a usual. Second property. Now comparison. Comparison with what we know. Comparison with, let me say, this formal geometry. So if lambda, in fact, comes from its derived category, and so what does it mean? This means that it's a torsion sheaf over N, and G, this means that it's a category of discrete G modules, torsion, and moreover, C, it's finitely generated in the previous sense. This means that it's just cohomology of such complexes are finite groups, finite. And so in this situation, one can associate real etal sheaves in formal geometry, and so then in this situation, there is a canonical isomorphism. And so, it is isomorphic, and we consider analytification. So first of all, this object without analytification is something which is defined here, in formal, but it is a sheaf on the special closed fiber of X, and so it is closed fiber is an analytic space, is a scheme over C, we consider its analytification, and so it's an analytification of these sheaves, and it is the same as And so there is a functorial canonical isomorphism of this object. And so if such a complex comes from just torsion discrete G module or complex of such modules, then we get the same we had earlier. Okay, the next property, given a generator, given a generator omega of the maximal ideal of K. So if we are given a generator, then we can construct a homomorphism from this ring to the ring of integers, which takes the coordinate function z to omega. First of all, let me fix it. And so if we are given also a scheme, now, if we are given situation like here, precisely the same situation like here, this means that we are given a morphism, complex analytic morphisms, morphism of germs of analytic spaces, and scheme over this local ring. It's precisely such a situation. And so if we fix a generator of this ideal, then there is such a homomorphism, and this homomorphism identifies the formal completion, the adic completion of this ring to this with the ring of integers. And so let we denote by x bar, x hat, the formal completion of this scheme along its closed fiber, which is denoted in such a way. And so it is already special formal scheme. Scheme over, it can be considered as a special formal scheme of the ring of integers due to this identification. Now the statement is that the vanishing cycle sheaves, which were defined in complex analytic geometry in such a situation, are canonically isomorphic to these complexes we are talking about. And so is it, again, in the situation, in the first situation, we were the situation in formal geometry, we get the same object. If we come from complex analytic geometry, we get this object, what we had in analytic geometry. In particular, the like philosophical meaning of this statement that in such a situation, all those vanishing cycle sheaves depend only on the formal completion of this formal scheme. For example, cohomology of Milner fiber depend only on the formal completion of this local ring of this Milner fiber. But in fact, one can say more. I can already, we do not need algebraic geometry because it just I'll continue. It's property number 4. It's property number 4. Given a subscheme Y of the closed fiber of this formal scheme, again, now X is a formal scheme like here. There is a canonical isomorphism. So let me write down. And so we restrict this complex to this subscheme Y, it is the same as we just we calculate the following. We consider the formal completion of X along this subscheme and consider its generic fiber. It's also a special formal scheme. Then there is such an isomorphism. Again, if you consider, for example, just B is C itself, and X is a scheme of finite type over this local ring, then complex analytic vanishing cycles, for example, restricted to a closed point, depends only on the formal completion of this scheme at this closed point. No, here X is just formal scheme X special. Now, forget about this property. This property, it is a scheme. Here I am back with a situation when X is a quasi-compact special formal scheme over the ring of integers in this property. This means that if you calculate these complexes defined here for X and we restrict to the subscheme of the closed fiber, it is the same as, in fact, it is a morphism. In fact, this morphism is just what I introduced this homomorphism for the following, for the morphism of formal schemes. And so if you have a subscheme of the closed fiber, we can consider its formal completion, and there is a morphism of special formal schemes. It's precisely this. The statement is that this homomorphism is an isomorphism. Okay, and the last property which I before formulated, continuity property. In fact, everything depends only, so the statement, that there is a canonical isomorphism. So we consider just very simple complex Z, nothing else. But we consider tensor product with lambda, and there is a canonical isomorphism. And so, in fact, the only, in a sense, unknown is this complex for Z when we consider Z. And so in et al. Cohomology of schemes and of analytic spaces, one doesn't consider such a tal sheaf like Z. But in this situation, also we have such a sheaf, but if we apply the previous construction to this sheaf, we do not get anything like that. Okay, and so you remember that the group pi X on all these sheaves, not G, not the Galois group, but the smaller group pi. Okay, now I formulate continuity effects. So continuity. And so in fact, continuity, there are two facts which one can deduce from the previous fact, but let me first of all, and so given X, again, X is a quasi-compact special formal scheme over the ring of integer, but this I call regular generic fiber. Regular, or I call it also Rigg smooth. So this means that it is a so-called strictly K-analytic space, and so this regular means that the local rings of all rigid points, which people consider in rigid geometry, are regular, or I call such spaces Rigg smooth. There exists n such that for any y, so it's a Gothic y with regular generic fiber, for any pair of morphisms from Y to X of morphisms of formal schemes such that they are congruent modulo G to the power N, where G is an ideal of definition of Y. We can take maximal ideal of definition. These two homomorphisms, and for any lambda, also these two homomorphisms coincides. This form of continuity is much stronger than this one, because here the ideal of definition depended on lambda. Here, under the assumption that the generic fiber is regular, for example, it is a situation for Milner fiber. Usually one considers germs of analytic spaces just smooth complex analytic spaces. So it is this situation is okay. So there is then for any two such morphisms, these two homomorphisms coincides. And so in this situation for schemes, if you came from complex analytic geometry, then I think that we didn't know this fact. Okay, it's something new we learned about complex analytic vanishing cycles. Now, I mentioned my time goes to the end, and so I'll mention only something which fascinates me, and which is something I'm more interested to with applications to non-Archimedean geometry from in the opposite direction from complex geometry. And so let X be a compact, strictly K analytic space. And so compact, and so this means that it's what is in rigid geometry one calls quasi-compact, quasi-separated, rigid analytic space. But here it just, okay. Then one can find there exists a formal scheme, a formal model of X. What does it mean? Renault theory. Renault implies then there is that is a formal scheme. Of finite type, not special, but of finite type over K of the ring of integers. Now, what does it mean, finite type? This means that you see in that definition, the second part of this formal, there are no formal power series, only the first part, restricted power series. This means that formal scheme of finite type, such that X is just the generic fiber of X. Now, let us define the following. And so lambda is a pi module, finitely generated over Z. For example, Z itself. With trivial action of pi, I define the following group. I denote in such a way. Again, it is a notation. The left-hand side, the same field. The same field. Nothing changes. So I define the following. And so it just, the left-hand side is, all this is a notation. The right-hand side, we consider the complex, which is defined in this theorem. In fact, probably the most curious thing, which is absent here, I did not explain the construction of this functor. But so we have some complexes, and we consider the derived functor of the functor, high direct images of the functor of global sections on this complex. So we define such a group. So now we fix, so for any x, fix its model x, curly x, gothic x, model with this property. And so I define this group. So the fact this correspondence is functorial. And so these groups are provided with, these are finitely generated abelian groups provided with the action of the group pi. So pi acts on these groups. So it's a finitely generated, because cohomology sheaves of this complex are algebraically constructible, and one knows that all such groups are finitely generated. It's a notation. Ah, x bar, I can explain x bar is just, okay, but all this is a notation. But x bar, okay, x bar is x, let me, it's x lifted to the completion of the algebraic closure. Why, now we'll see why this notation is good, is natural. And so, oh, I'm sorry, lambda, I should write here lambda, is functorial on x, in x. And so it's functorial. If we fix for every x its model, and we define these groups, it is functorial. So first property. Second, if lambda is finite, just finite. In particular, it depends only up to a unique isomorphism, canonical isomorphism. So we fix, we define in such a way, after that it's functorial. In particular, it doesn't depend. It doesn't depend, but it depends like up to a, this functor like is defined up to a unique isomorphism. It's better to say in such a way, because now if lambda is finite, then these are just etal cohomology groups of x bar of this analytic space, which is defined here, if lambda is finite. But if lambda is z, it's something new. Now, what it is? And so what we have from this fact? Okay, I can. It follows from for any prime L, and so this object, these are finitely generated groups. If a tensor with QL or ZL over Z, these groups are canonically isomorphic to the etal cohomology group, eladic cohomology group of X bar or ZL. So this means that eladic cohomology groups in this situation have Z structure. So over such fields. Particular case, by the way, of such a compact, strictly K-analytic space. Just we start Y proper scheme over K, and just X is the analytification. Analytification of X, and so do we, and so in that case, so what do we have? The right-hand side in this situation, the right-hand side, it just coincides by comparison theorem with et al. Cohomology groups of Y bar with QL, eladic of this scheme. So this means that eladic cohomology groups of such a proper scheme over this field have this structure. Now I already, my time is over, and so I only say that can tell that there is also very natural property that if we have such a situation like here, an anamorphism from such a compact space to the analytification of the scheme, which comes from such a complex analytic situation, then so for that scheme we have integral cohomology groups. And so here we have integral cohomology groups. There is a canonical homomorphism in the opposite direction. In particular, if in such a situation Y comes from a proper scheme over the fraction field of okay. If Y comes from a fraction field, a proper scheme over this field, fraction. And so we have integral cohomology groups. We can associate with it with a complex analytic space. It has integral cohomology groups. And so, but we can consider also analytification of this scheme. And so we get these groups. Now the last thing, it's only a conjecture I do not write. And so the conjecture is that these groups are provided with a mixed coach structure, which also functorial on in X. And in the case when such X comes from a proper scheme over such field curly K, it is precisely the limiting mixed Hodge structure of this scheme, which there is such a notion. And so more or less that's all. And so there is an evidence that this conjecture is true, because I know that in such a situation, the weight zero subspace of this limiting Hodge structure depends on the non-Archimedean identification of the space. But it turns out that, I hope so, the whole limiting Hodge structure just lives in the non-Archimedean world. So that's all, I think. I'm sorry, I see that it's more than 5 minutes.